My research in at the lab involves a field called connectomics. This field originated with the work of Santiago Ramón y Cajal, who is a very famous Nobel Prize-winning neurobiologist. And what Cajal did was use a regular light microscope to actually take a look at neural tissue, and with incredible ingenuity and understanding and intuition, he figured out how neurons were connected, even though he couldn't actually see the synaptic connections between them. So he was the father of a field called connectomics, where we study the connectivity in neural tissue, try to get kind of maps of these neural networks. You know, and the idea here is that in order to see the synapses, we actually need to use electron microscopy. So what we do in a modern connectomics pipeline is we take an animal, we take its brain, we embed the brain in a resin, then we take that resin, that block of resin, and we slice it tens of thousands of times with a microtome, put it on a tape, take the tape, this brain now on tape, put it on disks, and stick these disks into an electron microscope. And with the electron microscope now, we can get the resolution that we need in order to actually see the connections. And so if you have this image, this very accurate image from an electron microscope, now what we can do is actually take these images. Here's a block of images from an electron microscope. And we take, you know, in each slice, we can identify where the neuron is, okay, by kind of segmenting it. And from this, we can get the actual connectivity between these neurons, okay? And so the idea here is that modern connectomics is actually highly dependent on the quality of the images that we get. Now, if you look, okay, take, for example, a cubic millimeter of a brain of an animal, okay? A cubic millimeter is like a grain of salt. Okay? And in this grain of salt, you'll have 100,000 neurons and probably a billion synapses. Okay? It's the size of what you see. This is a pixel of fMRI, but for an electron microscope, this cubic millimeter will have 2,000 billion billion pixels in it. Okay? If I want to actually scan this with a regular single beam electron microscope, this is going to take me 60 years, one cubic millimeter. Okay? So what we do is we buy really expensive multi-beam microscopes that very few labs in the world can afford. And these have 90, 61 or 91 beams, and now I can actually get a reasonable speed. It'll take me a year to do this. So what can we do to kind of try to make these, you know, the single beam microscopes do, you know, the cheaper ones do what the expensive ones do and kind of make every lab be able to have, you know, a powerful microscope? Well, we can use the fact that these images, right, when I look at them from the point of view of connectomics, I don't really need all of the image, right? As far as I'm concerned, really, I just want to kind of understand where the membranes are. I want to spend time on the membranes, but I don't need to spend time on everything else if what I want is just to extract the connectivity here. And so the idea is, right, not to spend the same amount of time, beam time, on every pixel. Instead, you know, what we're going to do is kind of try to get the same quality. Here you can see an image that shows you what the accuracy you'd get with different dwell times. If you spend 25 nanoseconds, you're going to have a lot of errors. If you spend above 800 nanoseconds, you're not going to have a lot of errors, okay? But it's going to be very slow. So the question is, can we actually pick regions where we want to do things slowly and pick other regions where we're going to do this quickly and have this hybrid combination of the two deliver accuracy and speed, right? That's what we want. We want essentially to combine these two ideas, okay? So a SmartEM pipeline would look like, okay, take your microscope, use the GPU attached to it to actually, you run a fast scan through the image, okay, let's say 25 nanoseconds, 50 nanoseconds, and then even though you can't segment it accurately, what you can do is predict where your problems are going to be. Go back and rescan only those areas. Okay, that's the beauty of the thing. We can actually go back and rescan just those things, and then use this combined image to actually get an accurate segmentation. So the idea then is that when I look at the dwell times that I need, right, what I'm going to essentially achieve, you know, is the same kind of accuracy that I get with 1,000 nanoseconds, okay, but do it with a lot less time. While maintaining, of course, the same kind of accuracy, the same ballpark of accuracy. So let me show you what this looks like. So here you have on your right, you can see a ground truth, right, which is just a segmentation with a low speed. And you can see that it's segmenting it beautifully. Now, if I do this with a very high speed, I have this blob in the middle, this yellow blob, which is a bunch of neurons glued together. I run my detection, and I detect where there are problems. You see the blue marks are where a machine learning algorithm has detected there are going to be problems in the segmentation. I take these areas, and I dwell on them for a longer time. And then I have a combined image now that is the slow and the fast. And you can see that I can now have a correct segmentation. So I take, you know, an image. I run a fast acquisition. I rescan the problematic regions, I reconstitute the image, and now I have an accurate result. And this delivers, you know, typically you can get, you know, right now we're just in the beginning of building this technology, you can get about 7x improvement, you know, and you can do that with almost no error. And the future, of course, is to use this everywhere. Hopefully you can make labs all over the world use this kind of technology. And we can use it not only for biology, but also perhaps for material science, for detecting errors in VLSI circuits, those kinds of things. You know, the 10x that I showed you or the 7x is not the limit. You can, you know, the limit of this thing could be even 100x if we push it hard. And this is joint work between Harvard, MIT, and the people at Thermo Fisher, which really bring their expertise in building microscopes to this problem. Thank you very much.